My name is Sophie Darlington and I'm a wildlife camera woman.
Julie Moniere, I'm mainly additional camera person, working with a material called a run-in, but also doing time lapses, and I'm also helping Sophie.
We're here, part of the Disney film crew, to make a feature film about a daily penguins.
The film is about an adult who's going to become a dad for the first time and a struggle to raise two chicks until they can fledge and go to the sea.
It'll be the life cycle of an Adélie penguin, but that doesn't do the story justice. It'll be the most amazing comedy, drama, adventure, travel story you'll ever see. I've never seen or worked with an animal that has more charisma. They are natural film stars.
The Adélie penguins are very curious, but after a while, if you stay in one area, it's actually quite interesting. They start not caring about you and they kind of get used to you. But what really surprised me is how resilient those little guys are. It doesn't matter what the weather's going to be like, what the wind speed is going to be like, they're still going out to sea, getting some food, or in the colony feeding their chicks.
They're absolutely priceless. They don't know they're funny, but they are beyond funny. And you'll be sitting filming and suddenly, you know, a couple will hurtle past and fall over, and they're so covered in down, you know, they just get right back up. They're the perfect subject for a Disney movie. What child would not fall in love with an Adélie penguin?
I love them.
There's a few challenges to working here, which I'm not particularly familiar with. I've worked in the Arctic, but the Antarctic gives you it's a whole new set of things to play with. Isn't it famous for being the windiest place on Earth?
Yeah, the two big challenges is really the wind and the cold. But you just have to put layers up, and the wind is nothing you can do. It's just it's a killer.
Today it's beautiful, it's summer in Antarctica. It's gorgeous, the sun's out, the Adélies are all preening, it's fantastic. Within 20 minutes we can have a full-on storm here.
You can get really cold. We have to wear very thin gloves to be able to touch our equipment and to get a feel, to be able to focus.
There's so many challenges. And then there's the logistics. We're 70 miles from the nearest base.
First time you come here and you get helicopter in Cape Crozier, and then the helicopter goes, then it's you by yourself. And that's quite scary.
It's full of challenges, which makes it much more rewarding. It's an extraordinary and unreal reality. You wake up, you've got to prep your food for the day, you've got to melt your snow, you've got to charge your batteries, put on your generators. It's just a whole different way. You've got to change your mindset.
We do make a plan every morning about what we're going to be filming. And then we get here and the weather is going to do something very different. So it's always very difficult to know what you're going to be filming.
We can be here and this is going on, but 100 meters away, you wouldn't even know it was happening. So it's a matter of sort of sussing out what's going on, what changes have happened.
We work about 9 to 10 hours a day. You could do 24 hours, obviously.
By the way, I'm thoroughly confused by this 24-hour daylight thing. I don't get it. You get up and it's light, you go to bed, it's light. If you wanted to, you could work yourself to the ground.
Our camp is way up the hill, and it takes about 40 minutes to hike up back to camp, which, you know, can be challenging when you're tired after a long day at work. But I think it's also very good that we're that far away from the colonies, so we don't disturb them.
So we head up at around 10 or 11, home for midnight, spot a dinner, try and get to sleep, repeat.
National Science Foundation gave us the permission to come to Cape Crozier, which is a protected area, and we feel very privileged and lucky to be here.
You've no idea the amount of effort that goes into something like this, the months and months of planning. Getting us out here is such a huge operation, because it's not just us, it's our tents, it's our fuel, it's our food, it's our gear.
Making a Disneynature film for children is very important for science.
And it's that hand in hand, science and wildlife filmmaking going together. So We're building and working on the research that's been done here for years. And without the National Science Foundation, we couldn't have done it.